Welcome to the Financial Jungle. This is Share Khan Podcast.
Hello everyone, welcome again to Share Khan Podcast. Hope you all are healthy and safe. Today we talk about another IPO, Barbeque Nations Limited. Kindly note, this is an informational piece on IPO which is based on the RHP filed by the company with SEBI and not a recommendation. Barbeque Nation Limited, BNL, owns and operates Barbeque Nation, one of India's leading casual dining restaurant chains. The company has steadily grown, owned and operated the network of Barbeque Nation restaurants, starting from a single restaurant in 2008 to 147 restaurants across 77 cities in India and 6 international restaurants in 3 countries outside India as on December 31, 2020. The company also owns and operates Toscano Restaurant, which is an Italian cuisine brand, and UBQ, which is predominantly catering to delivery segment. Around 70% of the total restaurants are present in metros and tier 1 towns. One of the main contributors to the brand affinity has been referrals and recommendation by its customer, which has enabled the company to retain a strong market position. As of December 31, 2020, BNL's average rating on an online food aggregator was 4.38 out of 5 and has over 1 million followers on its Facebook main page. The company is planning to open 20 plus restaurants in FY22. The number of in-dining covers served at Barbeque Nation restaurant in India increased from 6.86 million in FY2017 to 9.92 million in FY20 at a CAGR of 13.08%. Further, average per cover for dine-in customer in India has grown from Rs. 707 in FY17 to Rs. 764 in FY20 at a CAGR of 2.62%. Compared to industry standards, BNL has higher proportion of weekday sales, which stood at 53.6% in FY20, and lunch cover, which stood at 44.4% in FY20. Sales has seen equal contribution from weekdays and weekend sales. Barbeque Nation restaurants are popular choice for corporate lunches during the week and families during the weekend. The company benefits from strong processes and systems that have been established over the past 14 years of operation. It controls over rent to revenue ratio is also successful. Central reservation system, customer feedback systems are also managed successfully. The company has a significant online presence. In 8 months of FY21, over 60.8% of total reservation was made online. Let us also look at some key concerns. Outbreak of COVID-19 pandemic had severe impact on businesses. Rising cases remain a risk. Also, company's profitability remained lower despite strong growth in revenues. BNL faces competition from the restaurant industry in general and the CDR market in particular. Inability to respond to competition might hit financial performance. Now, let's look at the financial highlights. BNL's revenue registered a CAGR of 20% over 2018-20 to Rs. 847 crore. The number of in-dining covers grew at CAGR of 13% over FY17-18. Gross margin stood at 65% in last 3 years. The consolidated OPM of the company decreased 19.4% in FY20 from 23.2% in 18. The company incurred consolidated losses due to loss incurred by international operations Johnny Rocket Restaurant, which were discontinued by the company in FY19. And also, some of its expenses have grown relatively faster than revenues from operation. Higher finance cost and depreciation expenses resulted in loss at PBT levels in FY20. The company has managed to bring down consolidated debt on books to Rs. 223.6 crores in 8-month FY21. Business recovered to 84% of the pre-COVID level in the month of November 20. Talking about valuations, at the IPO price band of 498 to 500, the offer is valued at 16 times to 16.2 times its FY20 EV by EBITDA. BNL's revenue clocked a CAGR of 20% over FY2018-20. Addition of 70 restaurants in last 2 years, losses in international business and divested businesses affected the profitability of the business. Though business has recovered to 84% of the pre-COVID level, but rising cases remain a key risk to the recovery. However, the long-term structural story of casual dining space in India is intact on back of improving demographic. This, along with better business model, negative working capital, improving operating cash flow, and focus on expansion in the key markets, would help the company to deliver better operating performance in the coming years in the backdrop of stable macro environment. The issue opens on March 24, closes on March 26. Face value is Rs. 5 per share with price band of Rs. 498 to 500 per share, bid lot of 30 shares and in multiples thereof. For more details, disclosures and disclaimers, please refer to our IPO note or contact our nearest branch. It's been a pleasure bringing you the Sher Khan podcast and thank you for listening in as always. Please read the risk disclosure document issued by SEBI and relevant exchanges and the terms and conditions on www.sherkhan.com before investing.
Investment in securities market are subject to market risks. Read all the related documents carefully before investing.